So this morning, just want to come at you with something that's been on my heart, man. You know, there's people out there in the world that can't bear children, right? They can't have children. They're barren, right? The womb is closed. And it's a very hurtful thing, right? Because that child represents life. That child represents legacy. That child represents a furtherance of that bloodline. You dig? So, you know, it's very important to women and men that they have a child to carry on their name, their line, their lineage, their legacy. So for those that don't have children, this is very hurtful. But I wanted to come at you from a different kind of perspective on this Testify Tuesday, you dig? I wanted to come at you from the perspective of barrenness, but not necessarily with children, but dealing with your future, you dig? Have you ever been in a situation, man, to where you really wanted something really bad, right? You prayed about it, you fasted on it, you know, you sought God many a day, many a night. You've been on your knees in prayer, seeking God for this thing that you've been asking for and pleading and begging, you know, all these things, right? You've been waiting for a while for this particular thing to manifest. It's extremely important to you. And it has everything to do with your future. And you pray on these things, And after so much time has passed, after so many days and months and or years have passed, and it still has not come to fruition. It still has not manifested itself, this thing that you've been praying and pleading and begging God for. Well, I just want to encourage you on today. Okay? For you guys that have been begging and crying and asking and pleading God for this particular thing, right? I just want to encourage you today with the scripture, right? I want you to sing and I want you to rejoice because your future is coming. It's been promised. Hey, yo, yo, what is it? You already know what it is, man. This is your man, Levon, and this is Levon Says. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new for the first time, this channel is all about love, uplifting, motivating, inspiring, learning, laughing, encouraging, and enlightening one another to be our best selves for the Lord. You dig? Remember to share this video with all your family and friends. Like this video if you haven't done so already. And please hit that bell notification after you subscribe so you'll always be notified upon my next video upload. You dig? I upload Monday through Friday, Mondays, Tuesdays, Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. You can catch all your motivation and inspirational needs on this channel, Levon Says. You know, many a times, man, we'll make plans. Right? We'll make plans. We'll have these grand dreams and big dreams about how we expect our life to be and where we want to go and what we want to do and, you know, how many kids we want to have and marriages and cars and houses. You know, we make all these grand plans, right? And there's a few of those plans that we may have had since childhood. We may have had carried with us for a long time. And for whatever reason, those things don't come to pass, right? And I'm just using children as an example, okay? Not specifically talking about children, but I'm using children as an example. And in this particular passage of scripture I'm going to use the scripture as an example. All right. So there's many times we make all these plans, right? We plan from a little bitty boy, a little bitty girl, you know, what we want, how we want it, what color we want it, you know, when we gonna get it, what we gonna do with it when we get it. We have all these grand plans and schemes, but what happens? What do you do when that thing that you've been dreaming about since a child, that thing that you've been wanting for so long, doesn't happen? You still don't have it. You've tried to work toward it. You try to, you know, make plans to get it. You've tried everything in your power to obtain it, but it just keeps slipping through your grasp. You can't seem to grasp it. It eludes you. You know what I'm saying? It gets to the point to where you're frustrated. You're upset. You're irritated. You cry out to the Lord. You know, you're crying, you're begging, you're pleading throughout the time and the years as time goes. You're still asking, you're seeking, you're wondering why, what's going on, why isn't this working, right? You get to the point to where you start to build anxiety. You start to worry about this thing. You start to question your faith and question your dedication. You start to buy into the trick that it's something you're doing, is something that you're not doing, that is not meant for you. You've been wasting all this time. Move on, you know, let that die and go on with something else, right? But there's something in you that just, it won't let go. You can't give up on this thing that you've been holding on to for so long, because in your mind, this is your future, right? So scripture says in Isaiah 54 and 1, it says, sing, O barren, right? Whatever your barrenness is, okay? So let the scripture speak to your heart this morning. So if you're barren, barrenness, being barren, not being able to carry a child, right? Childless. I don't know how any other way to that you can call it, but what is barren in your life? Is your prayer life barren? Is your giving causing you to be barren? Are you barren in your giving? Are you barren in your interceding? Are you barren in your fasting? You know, are you barren in reading your word? Are you barren in taking part in worship service? Are you barren in Bible study? Are you barren in just being a kind person? Are you barren in being loving? Is your love, are you barren in the love department? You know, are you barren in being humble? What are you barren in? The area that you're barren in, that you've been crying and pleading and begging and asking God for, that area that you're barren in is the area that God says in his word that you ought to sing and cry aloud, because those that are desolate, your children are going to be greater. In other words, you're no longer going to be barren. Rejoice about that. If you're barren in whatever area it is that you've been barren for a long time, you have not been able to produce, you have not been able to carry, you have not been able to house the blessing that is to break forth, right? Because you've been barren. Sing. It's the first thing is telling us this morning, for those of us that have been barren in certain areas, right? Sing. It's time out for tears. It's no more time for crying. It's no more time for boo-hooing and feeling sorry for yourself and saying, oh, woe is me. Why these things haven't taken place? What am I doing wrong? Look, stop all that. Kill all that. First thing you need to do for those that are barren, that thing has been escaping you, eluding you for a long time, The first thing God says do is sing. Sing, O barren. Thou that did not bear, right? Break forth into singing. Break forth. Break forth into singing. Didn't say whether you felt like singing. Didn't say whether it was appropriate time. Didn't say, any of that. How you felt about it. Who was around? Who watching? It says, you that are barren. It's talking to you. You that are barren. It says, break forth in singing. And cry aloud. Don't be silent. I don't want nobody to know my business. I don't want nobody to know what I've been going through. Man, you better open your mouth and you better break wide. You better break out singing, right? And it says, and cry aloud, thou that did not travail with child. For all of you that did not bear, you did not have the luxury of carrying the blessing and birthing the blessing. You have no idea what it feels like to be in travail with the blessing, right? You have no idea what it feels like to go through and to be praying and to be fasting and to be seeking God and believing God with the blessing that you know is about to birth forth. It's about to come forth. Your future is about to come forth, right? Your legacy is about to come forth, right? It says, cry aloud, thou that did not travail with child. It says, for more are the children of the desolate. Right? More are the children of the desolate. Those that are without, those that have gone without, they have been desolate. They've been barren. You know what I'm saying? They haven't had a future to look forward to. They haven't had any good news. They haven't had any breaks. It says here, to you that are barren, sing and cry aloud, right? To rejoice. Why? For more are the children of the desolate than the children of the married wife, saith the Lord. Check this out, man. Be encouraged today. You did? Be encouraged because your blessing is coming. Your blessing is finna break through. You dig? God is saying, sing aloud, right? Sing aloud and break forth with a loud cry. Why? Because your future's not dead. Your legacy has not passed you by. You know what I'm saying? God says, more are the children of the desolate. In other words, greater is your blessing and greater is your future. Greater is it for you that are barren, that have been seeking God, that have been yearning for God, that have been looking for God, that have been praying and fasting and been asking God. He said he's a rewarder of those that diligently seek him. Did he not? So if you believe that he's a rewarder of them that diligently seek him, and you've been seeking him diligently about your future, right? About your legacy, about what's going to happen, what God is going to do in your life, how he's going to bring forth, you know, things to happen in your life to where they have a greater effect on your future and those that are coming behind you. He says, sing and cry aloud. Why? Because your future is great, right? Great are the children of those that are desolate, right? For all those that have plenty and have much and their legacy is secure and they're not worried about their future, this is not talking to you. But for those of you that thought your life was over, you didn't have no future, you had no destiny, you had no legacy, the Lord says, not so. For all of you that are in that category, you better sing now. You better cry aloud. Why? Because he said, greater is the children of those that are desolate. Greater is the blessing of those that are without. Greater is coming to those that don't have. So be encouraged on today. Be encouraged on today about your future, that your future is secure, your future is bright, that your legacy does have a place in Christ. You dig? This is your man, LaVon. This has been LaVon Says. Please like, share this video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. And remember, man, Lamella E, love, uplift, motivate, inspire, learn, laugh, encourage, and enlighten. LamellaE.com. This is your man, LaVon. Please remember, your future is secure in Christ. You dig? One love, your man, LaVon, and I'm out.